and vice versa. It's going to be interesting to see, but we are not going to be seeing Ratapai on that Disc Priest. Instead, he has a treat for us on this restaurant. A treat.
Also, I do want to say that lands are going to be even more important this year than we have typically seen. When we see the point qualifications, that is going to be off of that number one seed for each region. Everything else going to be determined by those lands. There's a chance that you only see one team from EU or only one team from NA if they aren't able to get done that work at the lands.
Triple stun early on into a fear. Good crowd control by Plot Twist, but damage denied by SoQueen's Peels. Great polymorph placing. Still low health on Ratcher. That Glider safeguard shredded through. Ratify needs to make a quick decision. What does he want to commit cooldown-wise to recover? He's underreacting. Iron Bark now enough to stabilize potentially. Spell lock interrupting the heals. Now Ratcher back to full health. Numla is exchanging life cocoon, expecting incoming crowd control and trying to predict it, but surprise effect, hold on to the diminishing returns. Ratapai not standing in the best position so far, getting caught in huge crowd control chains and really putting his team behind.
Yeah, definitely. Ratcher forced to retreat once again. He's going to be looking for a re-stealth in this matchup. Inferniana midfield, getting good control onto SoQueen, manages to land the full fear. Does he have any damage? Now, when we've seen this matchup play out in the past, the Rogue Mage Druid, if they can stall long enough, really avoid the incoming damage from the Destruction Warlock, later on in Dampening, they can take him down. Numb is susceptible to crowd control like we kind of talked about earlier today, but it looks like Rezus will be the main focus here for surprise effect early on. Ratapai getting a full Cyclone on it. Numb is Rezus forced to trade out his Touch of Karma. A little bit of trouble.
Whoa.
Gets low. They shred through it. They have a lot of damage. Rezus could be in a lot of trouble. Fist of Fear with that Turbo Fist will deny any incoming damage from Ratcher with that 100% parry. Now full leg sweep. Ratcher still in some trouble. The Ratify caught into a crowd control as well off the back of that leg sweep. I think Ratcher will ultimately be able to survive.
Yep, they stay in it. Surprise effect looking to be the gatekeepers for Plot Twist to try and qualify to the Spring Finals. Numbless gets polymorphed on the Gladiator's Medallion, an opening here for surprise effect, but not enough damage. Another polymorph found. Do they have enough to take down? Rezus is the question. Glider's Maledict absorbing a lot of heals. Rezus actually getting aggressive onto Ratapai, maybe trying to stack them up for a double leg sweep. Ratapai repositions to avoid that incoming crowd control. Mana in favor of surprise effect. And although we know Ratapai for his devastating and now probably disgruntled Discipline Priest play, I'm glad that he is expanding his healer repertoire over onto the Druid in this specific meta. However, falling behind, Ratcher gets bursted. Ratapai is still crowd controlled. Glider Safeguard has been punched through. Chaos Bolt being casted. Cloak of Shadows denies that, but Touch of Death is rolling. Ironbark's defense is shortly going to fall. Rezus moves in for the final nail in the coffin here in game number one. Huge hit. Kill gets denied by the feint of Ratcher. Fist of Fury still flying. If a Chaos Bolt can connect, Infernion looking to bait and interrupt with that fear, not finding the bait, though. Not able to connect any damage. Rezus opting to peel back, realizing a smoke bomb could be a kill opportunity for Ratcher. He does not want to overextend during this moment in time.
Yeah, definitely a lot on the line here for Plot Twist, where surprise effect, this is easy breezy. They just want to look to play spoiler in this particular tournament, and things are looking pretty good for them so far in this matchup. Although Infernion gets his Infernals out, trying to empower his damage, finds a full fear on the SoQueen. Is there any crowd control on the Ratapai? There's the paralysis. What are they going to do? Rezus with a leg sweep on the Ratapai as they're looking to get some damage rolling, but SoQueen denies Infernion on his Dark Skull, on his Infernals with a spam polymorph. Once again, looking for another one. Ratcher lands a full kidney shot. Inferno has been denied on all his offensive cooldowns. Really not able to get anything rolling. Ratapai trinkets out. Good pressure here on Inferno. Life Cocoon trades out from Numbless before he goes into the Cyclone. And Ratapai, honestly, has been doing a really good job on this Restoration Druid. You can tell he's been practicing it.
Numbless in a Polymorph. Opportunity for surprise effect. Can they manage to pull it off here against Plot Twist? Ratapai switching over to the Restoration Druid is going to be pivotal in their victory here against Plot Twist. Numbless leaves the crowd controlled. They're relying on Unending Resolve to soak up all of the hits, but that may not be enough defense to stay alive as Infernion dips lower in health. Counterspell available for SoQueen. He's actually using that on Infernion. Numbless now leading the charge with that Wave of the Crane, looking to try and add some extra punch to his team. Not able to find it. Ratapai connects a huge heal, stabilizing the team. Mana in favor of surprise effect. Cooldowns in favor of surprise effect. And to be honest, with this being an alternative Rogue Mage. If Plot Twist cannot take out Ratipai Druid Rogue Mage, what hope do they really stand against? Change my mind. If they even manage to make it through this series, it could be a precursor.
Yeah, definitely a story of things to come here in game number one, depending on how it plays out. Plot Twist, once again, Numbla is caught into crowd control. Nicely done by Surprise Effect. If you look at mana, Ratipai actually has a lead here. And I really believe that the further this game goes, the more of an advantage Surprise Effect has with that Rogue Mage Druid control and the amount of consistent damage the Assassination Rogue brings onto the Destruction Warlock. It's just going to be a lot of pressure for Numbla to really deal with.
Yeah, let's see if he can. He's only got a bit more mana left in the tank for Wave of the Crane if he's relying on that for a big push. In this position, Ratchet does not have a Glider's Medallion. He will be caught in a full leg sweep that could add a lot of damage and take him out. But at the same time, Smoke Bomb is available and Infernion is overextended. Surprised to not see Ratchet just go for a Smoke Bomb play here onto Infernion. He gets Mortal Coiled away on the attempt into a Fear. Infernion stalling out as long as possible, but he's not able to stall the sap. Smoke Bomb is still available. They're going to drop it, deny any semblance of support from the team, and connect a huge chain of damage as Infernion gates back to center field. Cyclone on Numbless likely to secure the kill, and Infernion falls. Match, or game one, goes to Surprise Effect, and Ratipai looks to be the gatekeeper here today.
Oh, man. Numbless has looked incredible in the entire season. I think Numbless shows exactly what we... That's why Plot Twist is one of these teams where we've seen Numbless on the Shaman. We've seen him play the Druid. We've seen him play the Monk as well. This is what it really does take. That's why Plot Twist is still in range of making it to land, but Surprise Effect. Definitely hit him with a surprise in the first game. Let's see if Plot Twist can bring it back here.
I think Numbless has just realized that his Mistweaver is too susceptible to mage composition, so he's going to be playing the Shaman. And we've seen him be shaky, really, throughout previous tournaments on it. So this is his last chance to solidify that he is capable of diversifying over onto that healer. And it could be important for his team as he is likely facing Surprise Effect with a mage, and then Change My Mind with a mage. And if they can manage to make it through just these two teams, they will tie and then face ABC, who is probably also going to be a mage. So Numbless playing Shaman, this is his last chance to step up and show what he's got.
Yeah, he's got to warm up on that class for sure, and I want to see Plot Twist play very aggressive in this matchup. I really feel like as the game goes on, as we move into Dampening, the Destruction Warlock is just too susceptible to the Assassination Rogue. So you'll notice Plot Twist, they're not afraid to be trading out their Gladiator's Medallions early. A lot of these offensive cooldowns. So Queen still doing a good job cutting away. Ratipai able to back him up. Ratcher trying to create some pressure here onto Infernion, who's left behind. You'll always see Soulqueen as well as Ratipai. They're just constantly running away from Infernion. Infernion trying to reconnect, trying to find damage, but he's constantly snared by the crippling poison of Ratcher as well as the snares that the Frost Mage has available. And that's what makes it so difficult for the Destruction Warlock. When he finally does get there to get some damage out, he's into the Kidney Shot. And there's just a lot of pressure for Surprise Effect because of it.
All right, Infernion low on cooldowns and low on health. Surprise Effect look to try and just put Plot Twist on match point. If Plot Twist get knocked out here, they're going to be knocked out of contention for that fourth place position. There's a lot on the line for them. This is the last stop. Can Numbless pull it off on this Restoration Shaman? Ratchet really dishing out pain here on Infernion. Earthen Wall Totem is protecting him for now. Soulqueen gets stunned up, low health. Rezu's trying to push him over. Ratipai connects a huge heal. Temporal Shield soaks up the rest of it. Mana fairly even on both sides, but definitely a cooldown lead establishing itself in favor of Surprise Effect.
Yep. Infernion still just marching his way towards Soulqueen, who's just kiting away from him, keeping him snared up, and it's just difficult. Ratipai, in the meantime, he sneaks away. Is he going to be able to recover a lot of his mana? Soulqueen in a little bit of trouble here. This is greedy time for Surprise Effect. Ratipai was able to recover a ton of his mana, securing a lead. Soulqueen didn't even have to trade out an Ice Block. This is looking really good for Surprise Effect.
Yeah, it's looking better and better. Ratipai on this Restoration Druid's looking solid, and potentially we see a Rogue Mage Mirror again against Change My Mind. That would definitely be entertaining. Of course, we don't want to count Plot Twist out just yet, as there's a lot of pressure they're putting on ABC. If they can manage to squeeze through the next two series, they've managed to at least pull an Ice Block from Soulqueen and showing signs of life. Plot Twist certainly have what's necessary to find victory. They're so close to it. The one thing that the Restoration Shaman brings to the table is that purge. After the recent utility mana changes, Numbless could sneak in and be the X Factor for his team.
Definitely good pressure still on to Soulqueen. Ratipai's mana around 50%. Numbless significantly behind. There's a full blind. Numbless trinkets out. Doesn't want to fall behind on Infernion. He still has a Spirit Link. without his trinket, won't be able to have access to the that emergency cooldown on Will. Have to get out of crowd control. So if Surprise Effect can have an extended crowd control chain, they could take down Infernion. Infernion trades out the Infernals, looking to get some damage rolling. Good crowd control onto Ratapai. Good burst damage onto Soquin. He's trying to deny that damage with the Temporal Shield, and I think ultimately will be able to survive. But Infernion, he's just such a vulnerable target.
Yeah, Infernion going to be the weakness here defensively since those recent changes as well. So Queen getting pressured. Rezus trying to put the team on his back. Rezus has been the MVP on that Windwalker Monk. If anyone is going to be able to do it for the team Plot Twist, it will be Rezus. How much more can he do? He's got a 16-second window to get this second ice block before Iron Park's available. If he can stay on target, Ring of Peace to bounce So Queen back to him. He gets Frost Nova immediately on that Flying Serpent kick. Polymorphed on the Tiger's Lust. Windshirt, though, on the Dispel. Now Cyclone. Actually, Trinkets aggressively. Rezus is definitely trying to just end this match as quickly as possible, realizing that Numbless is now totally tapped on mana.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to throw it nearly as many purges, and that means Ratapai is going to have a much easier time keeping his team alive. Soquin now using the Icy Veins. He wants to get aggressive, realizing how vulnerable Infernion is with Numbless completely tapped on mana. Ratapai, what is he going to do? Still in a position where he can sneak away and go for drinks if he needs it. Ratcher using his Banish, getting a Garrote Silence on a Numbless, on Infernion, empowering his damage of that Garrote as well. Really putting out big pressure onto Infernion now into a full kidney shot. He trinkets out, doesn't want to be soaking up any damage. Needs to start looking for some counter pressure. There's a full polymorph, and Infernion, he's in a lot of trouble. Finds a Shadow Fear onto Ratcher, looking for a follow-up fear, manages to get the crowd control he needs to survive, but scary moments for Plot Twist.
Still zero mana on Numbliss. He's got Spirit Link Totem, but he's going to have to predict crowd control and get that off before it lands. Earthen Wall Totem placed down. That is enough defense for Infernion to stabilize. Spell Lock secured on Ratapai. Infernion setting up the team here to get a push onto Soquin. A couple more seconds till that Temporal Shield starts to heal Soquin back. Chaos Bolt's flying in. Iron Bark, though, should be enough for Soquin to stabilize. Hex snuck in, but removed by Soquin. Instant decurse on his part. Good utility. Mana starting to even out here as we pull into Dampening. Infernion stunned up. Where the opening Smoke Bomb available could be a big push, big power play, but Rezus once again putting the team on his back, secures a double leg sweep, forcing Ratchet to actually blind defensively, perhaps realizing they don't need crowd control to win. They can just overwhelm with damage, and Numbless having zero mana instead goes for a safer route and uses the blind defensively. Although it does limit their options aggressively, this is the safer route. Now sapping Rezus. Rezus been out of the fight for an extended period of time. Numbless has a tough decision to make here. Pops Ascendance, tries to recover. Counterspell available. He's going to need to be careful, activating that Spirit Walker's Grace right halfway through his cast to try and bait Soquin into using Counterspell into it. Now instead, Soquin using Counterspell into Infernion to stall out his damage. That defensive blind might come back to bite Surprise Effect, though, if they can't close this out. They've managed to secure mana from Ratapai, sneaking away, getting a drink. They've got good damage. Numbless is still totally tapped on mana, and Dampening is going nowhere but up.
Yep, and Infernion's in so much trouble. Spirit Link Totem, that's the last line of defense Numbless really has available. Now, at this point forward, Ratcher's damage is going to be huge. Vendetta up in 8 seconds. If Surprise Effect can hold on a little bit longer, they could close out this game. Infernion realizing he's in a lot of trouble, looking to counter pressure with his Infernals. Dark Soul not available for another minute, so isn't going to have that. But the Re-Stealth, or actually the Vanish from Ratcher, allows him to get a Growth Silence. Now full counter spell secured on a Numbless. Vendetta gets pulled out by Surprise Effect. They're looking to go up 2-0 in the series, but a big setup here from Rezus. He might be able to take down Ratcher. Ratcher doing everything he can to stay alive. Drops out the Cloak of Shadows as well as the Smoke Bomb, looking to avoid. Ratapai still in a fear. Ratcher flailing to live. Soquin doing everything he can as well. Surprise Effect, what a scary moment, but now it's Infernion who's in trouble.
Ratcher pre-fainted the incoming leg sweep. If he did not do that, he would be dead right now. We'd be a tied ball game, but by staying alive, he's kept his team in the fight. They've got a significant mana lead. There's no defense left for Infernion. All they have to do is connect and deal just a tad bit more damage. A counterspell on Numbless's heal could close the fight as well. Infernion, what are you going to do? I mean, Ratcher as well. Defense limited on both sides. Counterspell secured as Soquin looks to close. Icy Veins popped and too much damage for Infernion to handle. Surprise Effect move to match point and look to deny Plot.
Also, then you're in a situation if you see them both do that, like every single EU team goes, like every EU team goes to the finals, and there's one NA team.
Yeah, but that's what happened last year, and then the NA team won. Well, it was 5-2.
NA grand final, baby. Well, let's see if we will see that again this year. Surprise Effect, though, right now has just come back with a vengeance. Ratapai being the avenging angel of Discipline Priests around the globe.
little bit more disgruntled Discipline Priest, I think. Ratify, though, in a good position for his team, having brought this out here in the cup number 6 of the spring season, the final cup. Plot Twist, Numbliz, Shaman not able to step up and carry the team, so instead going back on the comfort of that Mistweaver, which is still susceptible to the crowd control that Surprise Effect bring to the table. Counterspell onto the Trinket of the Blind, potential opening for Surprise Effect to pull even more defensive cooldowns from Rezus. Rezus portals back out of line of sight, able to stabilize slowly but surely in the back line. Potentially a way of the Crane push onto Ratchet, but now Numbliz gets caught in a Polymorph. This is devastating for Plot Twist.
Yeah, Rezu's in a lot of trouble right now. He has a touch of Karma and Trinket. Doesn't want to be too greedy, though. Looking for a Fist of Fury to deny Rapture any incoming damage, but immediately the Kidney Shot lands. Rezu's getting lower. There's a full Cyclone onto Numbliz. Rezu's can't play this too greedy. Touch of Karma trades out. They might just try to shred through it. Numbliz does have the Life Cocoon. Might have to connect that, but ultimately Touch of Karma seems to be enough to keep Rezu's alive, but there is great pressure from Surprise Effect, and this is what we're kind of talking about. The Mistweaver Monk, they're very susceptible to crowd control. So that Mage and Druid setup, as long as they have good synergy, they can find these openings, these win conditions, but now Rezus Infernian looking to strike back. A little bit of pressure here on Soaking, but another setup. Numbliz caught in some crowd control. That breaks. Now Rezus going to be completely fine out of that Kidney Shot to make an aggressive push.
Rezus moving forward. Smoke Bomb still available, but with Thayer's Medallion, Rezus is likely to escape. Infernion running that Dark Simulacrum. He can steal crowd control. He stole a Cyclone earlier on and almost forced an Ice Block with it. They've actually got a significant mana lead, so while they are still far behind on cooldowns, they could win off mana. They need to try and make it to that point.
Uh-oh.
Rezus locked down in crowd control. Numbliz as well. Two members brought
Uh-oh.
Up to fight, and Rezus desperately trying to escape. Able to get around the corner finally, but Ratcher in position to continue the chain with that increased damage from stealth. Numbliz finally able to stabilize Rezus. Still a 19-second window. If So Queen can get a Polymorph, blinks in, gets Death Grip on it. Ratify instead with the presence of mind, realizing while his team had momentum to sit down, try and drink and regenerate mana, manages to pull himself closer to Numbliz. Good awareness on Ratify's part. Now Numbliz in a Polymorph. Curious, he stole it. Yes, great steal by Infernion. Ratify now in a Polymorph and Ratcher in trouble.
Yep, evasion gets traded out. Ratify gets out of the crowd control, and finally Ratcher gets some heals, but Maladic soaking up a lot of that. Ratify needs to find a moment to get out some cast, does manage to find a regrowth, topping off Ratcher immediately. Rezus now under fire, his portal in a much better positioning behind the pillar. It was a bit of a blunder earlier on, caught into the Kidney Shot, forced to use his Gladiator's Medallion, overlapped with the anti-magic zone of Infernion to stay alive. And Surprise Effect, surprisingly, they've had great opportunity in this matchup so far. Rezus basically forced to play very defensive and to run away. He's looking for counter pressure on Soaking, but gets denied on that healing. That was a Thunder Focus D from Numbliz. Ratify pushing in, making plays for his team. Rezus in a Kidney Shot, and they take him down. Surprise Effect closing out this series 3-0.
Feed versus the Fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.